So today we are discussing about the topic asset-based community development. Asset-based community development, as the word denotes, asset-based community development means we are focusing on the assets of the community rather than needs. And we are discussing about what is ABCD. And what is ABCD? That is asset-based community development is a strategy for sustaining community-driven development. That means it is based on the sustainable community-driven development. That is all the activities are done by the will be done by the community, and ABCD is concerned with how to link micro assets. That means micro assets, individuals, associations, institutions, and other resources available in the community. This micro assets is to be linked to the macro environment, that is the community development. That is the community can drive the development process themselves by identifying and mobilizing existing and unrecognized assets. That means unrecognized means they are not recognized yet these resources, and thereby responding to and creating local economic opportunity. There is an opportunity for the economic development and other development, community development, using this ABCD approach. And ABCD builds on the assets that are already found in the community and mobilizes individuals, associations and institutions to come together to build on their assets, not concentrate on their needs. The ABCD approach is not concentrating on their needs, but they are concentrating on this approach is concentrating on their assets also, assets, their resources. And time should be spent in identifying the assets of the resources, assets of the individuals, associations and their institutions, and after that they are working together to build a common identified assets of all involved. And the identified assets form an individual or with the people or groups who have an interest and need in that assets. The key is to begin to use what is already in the community. That is, the community will begin to use the what is available in the community, what is available resources in the community. That is the concept, the main concept of ABCD. We are focusing on the assets of the community. And what is the need of ABCD? This slide is explaining it. And the welfare system today, that is in such a way that professionals have made clients and recipients of the poor and robbing them of the support from their neighbors, who now think that they are not skilled enough to help. But this ABCD approach will focus on the strength of the community members. They have the skills, they have gift, and they can utilize these resources for the community development, their own development. That is the concept of ABCD. And this is a existing association and networks are assumed to be the source of constructive energy in the community. That is, the resources available in the community have the power to change the community, and this community should use these resources for their development. Community driven development is done rather than development driven by the external agencies. We are focusing on the community's resources, our own resources for the development. That is the main concept of ABCD. And ABCD pays particular attention to the assets inherent in social relationship, as evident in formal and informal association and networks. These are the resources available and assets available in the community. And what is ABCD? It is a community driven approach. That is, a community is the main focus of the community members, is the main focus of the ABCD approach. And there is also principles and practice of participatory approaches of development. And there is a active participation and empowerment. And it is a strategy directed towards a sustainable economic development that is community driven. That is, a main focus is the community driven. That is, a community take the responsibility, take the whole responsibility of the development. And next slide is which are the principles of ABCD. And first principle is, everyone has gift. That means everyone has the capacity, people can contribute and want to contribute, and this gift should be discovered, must be discovered. Everyone has gift, everyone has the potential to contribute. That means everyone, people can contribute and want to contribute, they want to contribute, and this gift must be discovered. That is the first principle of ABCD. And second one, relationship build a community. That means we should make the community members mutually make relationship, mutually should make the relationship. That means see them, make them, and utilize them. That is the second principle. And third principle is citizens at the center. That means community members should act. They are not just recipients, that they are not just clients, that they are not just recipients of services. That is a citizens at the center. Citizens should take the responsibility of the development. And fourth one, leaders involve others as active members of the community. That means local leaders, that is local individuals who have the power to influence other people, should involve others on active members. That means leaders from the wider community of voluntary associations, congregations, neighborhood, and local business associations can engage others from their sector. This is based on their trust, influence, and relationship. They should focus on these three things: trust, influence, and relationship. Next principle is people care about something. That means agencies and neighborhood groups often complain about apathy. That is people in their communities, people in the communities are motivated to act. That is the challenge is to discover what their motivation is. We have to discover the motivation of the people. What is their motivation? And next principle is motivation to act must be identified. That means people act on certain themes they feel strongly about, such as concern to address, dreams to realize, and personal talents to contribute. And what is their motivation? We should analyze, we should identify the motivation of the people. And every community has the motivation, has the invisible motivation for action. We should believe in that value, believe in that principle. Motivation to act must be identified. The next principle is listening conversation. That means one-on-one dialogue or small group conversation are always of discovering motivation and invite participation. We are focusing on the focus group discussions, and focus group discussions are small group. In the focus group discussion, there is a smaller group engaged in the conversation, and we can identify their motivation easily. And forms, surveys, asset maps can be useful to guide intentional listening and relationship building. And next principle is ask to the community members. That means asking and inviting, and we are asking them to come forward. Asking and inviting are the key community building action. And ask. That's the next principle, ask. And asking questions rather than giving answers invites stronger participation. Next principle, focusing on the participation of the members. Real participation of the members. We should ask the question. People in the communities are usually asked to follow you outside experts' answers for their community problems. A more powerful way to engage the people to invite communities to address the questions. And they should ask the questions, and they can find the answer. And next principle is a citizen-centered organization is the key to community engagement. Citizen-centered means local people control the organization. The local people should control the organization, and the set the organization's goals. That is a another principle. Next principle is institutions have reached their limits in problem solving. That means all the institutions such as government, non-profitable organization, non-governmental organization, business groups are stretched thin in their ability to solve community problem. They cannot be successful, and cannot be successful without engaging the rest of the community in solutions. That is the people's participation in asset-based community development is very much essential for the community development. And last principle is institutions as servants. All the other institutions and have essential role in the community development as the lead by stepping back, creating opportunities for citizenship, care and real democracy. Institutions as servants of the people. That is a different principles which we can apply in ABCD approach. And next slide is focusing on the five key assets in ABCD. What are the assets? Which are the assets available in the community? Asset ABCD approach. First of all, individuals, the residents of the community, they have gift and skills. So much gift and skills. Everyone has their own gift. That individual gift and assets need to be recognized. In community development, you cannot do anything with the community's people's needs. We should focus on their assets. And second one, associations. Small informal groups of people such as clubs working with the interest as volunteers are called associations. These clubs are very critical to community mobilization. Very critical. And they don't control it. They are not dealing with the people directly. And they don't control anything. They are just coming together and a common interest by their individual choice. That means associations are the key elements, key asset, one of the key assets in ABCD. Next one, institutions. These are the group of the people who are paid. Generally are the professional. That means governmental agencies, private business organizations, NGOs, non-governmental and other profitable, non-profitable organizations, schools, colleges, they can all be the valuable resources. The assets of these institutions help the community capture valuable resources and establish a sense of responsibility. That is another assets in ABCD. And next one, physical assets. Physical assets, that means land, buildings, space, funds, are other assets that can be used for the development. And next, there is connection. There should be connection. There must be an exchange between people, sharing their assets. These connections are made by the people who are connectors. They are the connectors. It takes time to find out about the individuals. This is normally done through building relationship between the individual by individual. That is, these are the five assets in ABCD. Let me discuss about the comparison of association and institution. You might have doubts about the association. What is association and what is institution? And we should explain. We can discuss about the what is association and institutions. Association, in this slide, how governed, power by consent, controlled environment. These are the main concepts related to associations and institutions. Associations are governed by power by consent. That means we have the decision to take the power of associations. Consent of the citizens is very essential in making associations. And institutions means we controlled by environment. We are indirectly involved in. And in association, decision made by association according to the choice of the members. In institution, involuntary decisions and powered by other people. And who designed for activities? Who designing the activities in associations? And design for and by each other, each members. Institution is designed for production. And who decide what to do in associations? The members. Members decides it. Institutions needs a client or customer. That is a client or customer decides what to do. Who runs the association? Citizen volunteers. Institution is a service, not a servant. Who are the beneficiaries of association? Citizen members. In institution, there is consumer or client. Function. Association have the freedom to function. But institution produces services. What drives? In association, capacity of the members drives the capacity. Capacity of the members drives the association. Institutions are driving to meet the needs of the members. Amount of control. There is institutions, tight hierarchical control by the members, but in association very little control. That means there is a slight, there is a of course a difference between associations and institutions. Then there is one more concept. What is social capital? Social capital refers to features of social organizations such as networks, norms, trust, which increase a society's productive potential. It built on a web of relationship that exists within any given community that allows people to succeed or advance through associating together. Social capital is present in the networks, norms, and social trust inherent in association whose members work together in concerned collaborative action. Social capital is store of goodwill and obligation generated by social relation. This is the ABCD. So building social capital is very much essential in provocating describing or implementing ABCD in community, for the community development, ABCD approach. These are all about ABCD approach. We discussed about the key concept of ABCD, and we discussed about principles. There are so much various principles related to ABCD, and which are the assets in ABCD. We are discussed there is comparison of association and institution, and what is the social capital. These are all about ABCD approach, asset based community development.